Continuing on with this discussion about methods, I just want to hit a couple of things. One is that, again, we don't need to pass in integers all the time. This could be a double. This could be a string, if that's what we are wanting to pass in and out. We define the type that's being passed in first and then give it a name. And so in this case, I did want two integers, but I could have written this method to use all doubles and then return a double, and that would have been fine too. The important part is this. Order matters. Because notice here, let's say I declared an int here called num and set it equal to 3, and then an int pow and set it equal to 5. Let's do 2 to the 5th. So 2 and 5. And then I, instead of passing in the actual number, I passed in the num and the pow on this end. Okay, now I name these things the same thing. I'm passing in a 2 and a 5. Again, that doesn't matter because these are separate variables in memory. Remember this little discussion here? 1 belongs to the main method. This num belongs to the main method. This num belongs to the power method. So if I run this, I'm going to get a result, and the result is 32, which makes sense. 2 to the 5 is 32. I want to make this point, though. If instead I pass in pow first and then num, this is going to drastically change this number. Okay? Well, I guess it wasn't that drastic. That was probably a little exaggeration. But it's 25 now. Well, why is that? Because now, instead of going 2 to the 5th, it's going 5 to the 2nd power. Now, what's interesting about that? Isn't this was supposed to be the power, right? The problem is I passed in the power first, and all we're interested in here is the slots. This is slot number 1. This is slot number 2. If we're looking at our doors in the little urinalysis station, we have two slots, 1 and 2. It's not each one has to go in the appropriate slot. Okay? So if I am expecting num to come in first, then I have to pass num in first. It has nothing to do with the names. It has everything to do with the position. Which position are we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if we had more information that we were passing in. The position is critical. And what that means is, if I really only want to pass in power, I can't just say, oh, just pass in power. It'll yell at me, first of all. It'll say, hey, you can't apply this method that required an int and an int, and what you're giving it is just an int. You need to have an int and an int in that order. One int represents the num, one int represents the pow. Okay? So if I'm going to pass that in, I need to pass in this piece of information first, and then this piece of information in second. And then the program functions correctly because it has everything it needs in the correct order. Again, I could call this blah, and I could blah, and I could call this yada. It doesn't matter. As long as I'm passing the appropriate information in the right position, then I should get the right result. Okay? All right, so let me just I'll put this back to the way we had it. It was to the 5th is what we had. And now I've got a 2 coming in this position and a 5 coming in this position, and that's the way we want it. First one's the number, second one's power. And again, we can, I don't know what the theoretical limit, maybe somebody out there does, of how many things you can pass into a method, but it's a lot, more than you'd ever want to. We can pass in as many pieces of information that we need to, but on that same point, we can only return one piece of information. One type, I should say. So what's coming back out is going to be one integer. in this case. It could be a double, it could be a string, it could be a long, it could be whatever we want it to be. In this case, it's an int. We can pass in to the method as many things as we want to, but we only return one thing. It has to come down to a centralized return statement that's going to return one piece of information. But there are ways to do what we need with that one return statement. We can pass in an array, we can pass in objects if we're needing to return more information. All right, so we've got kind of one more concept that I want to hit, but I'll go ahead and do that in the next video. We just have to keep in mind that position is what matters here, and we have to have our comma in to separate one position from the other. Spencer out.